big enough for Gord's feet?
12, yep. They have awesome. Some 12 pumps. Size 12. I think she's saving the leopard skin just for George, I was going to call him. He'll wish his name was George, yes. And not Gord, as he's wearing high heels.
We'll have the cameras out for that one. This week, Linda, we sort of go into the ditch, so to speak, mm-hmm. And then after September, things are starting to look a lot better. 15 degrees tomorrow, cloud showers. Same deal for the first day of school. I know many back at school today already, but Edmonton School Board back at school Wednesday. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, things look a little better, and then we're cooler again for Sunday.
Well, Friday, Saturday, that's okay.
Looks pretty good.
That's half the long weekend. Thanks for watching. We're back at 6 for the News Hour. But first, it is a quest for gold tinged with a bit of gray. And Alberta great-grandmother tossed the javelin this weekend at the Canadian Senior Games. We'll bring you the 97-year-old story next on Global National, anchored this week by our very own Gord Steinke.
Global National with Gord Steinke.
Hi, and thanks for joining us. It began as a dream adventure for dozens of tourists, a cruise to Canada's fabled Northwest Passage. But that journey came to a crashing halt. Their ship ran aground on Friday. It took all weekend before they were rescued in uncharted waters off Nunavut. As Robin Gill tells us, the crash has exposed some major safety concerns with these types of Arctic cruises.
With their feet firmly planted on the ground, they can now tell the story of being stranded in the middle of the Arctic.
Very strong jolt that kept going for a little while, and then we stopped, and the boat was on a tilt.
That happened on an adventure cruise through Canada's Arctic, a region Canadian folk singer Stan Rogers made famous with an iconic song.
I would take the Northwest Passage.
128 passengers and 69 crew members were on a 15-day cruise in the Northwest Passage. A day before the journey was supposed to end, the ship, the Clipper Adventurer, hit a submerged rock in the uncharted waters off Nunavut.
It was a shock to find it there. We weren't anticipating there being any rocks there. There was nothing indicated on the charts, and so really we didn't have too many options of what we could do at that point.
The Clipper Adventurer is run by a Mississauga company, which charges anywhere from $6,000 to $14,000 a person for an opportunity to experience the North. Historically, the Northwest Passage was an explorer's quest for glory, a northern link between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. But in recent years, it's become a coveted shipping route and a tourist mecca.
We could have seen a couple of hundred lives lost in the Northwest Passage.
Mike Byers is an Arctic scientist at the University of British Columbia. He recently spent 2 weeks on a ship in the same area. He believes there are too many risks and there needs to be more investment in a base there for certain rescue operations.
The navigation charts are not very good. The weather can be very unpredictable.
The Department of Defense says there were no real concerns with this case because the weather was fine, there were no injuries, and no environmental damage. As for the passengers, it was definitely an adventure they'll never forget.
One of the engineers said, you know, we learned from the Titanic, which I wasn't sure reassured me that much.
Robin Gill, Global News, Vancouver.
And as the sea ice melts and Arctic waters open up, tourists aren't rushing there in any great numbers just yet. The Coast Guard reports the number of cruise ships and private craft navigating the Arctic has held pretty steady over the past 5 years.
Coming up next on Global National, will a full day of learning now pay off when they're all grown up?
There's benefits to children and benefits to parents.
New findings about the kindergarten economy. Ontario works up a sweat. Nova Scotia braces for a hit. Weather extremes have Canadians on alert. Plus, the mystery of her missing father haunted her for years.
At least there is some closure.
Now, a secret frozen in time is finally revealed.
A Canadian soldier hit by a roadside bomb in Afghanistan earlier this month has died of his injuries. 21-year-old Corporal Brian Pinkson of Cornerbrook, Newfoundland, was in a vehicle that struck an IED near Kandahar City 8 days ago. He was flown to a German hospital but didn't pull through. 152 Canadian soldiers have now been killed in the conflict. It's back to school this week in some provinces, and next week, thousands of Ontario students will be spending more time in school than a year ago. That province is slowly rolling out a multi-billion-dollar full-day kindergarten program. While critics have complained about its costs, a new study shows it may just make a lot of sense and dollars. Here's Loren McNabb.
She's a five-year-old with an opinion.
Do you like to go to school all day, or do you like to go just for a few hours?
Like just for a few hours.
Problem is, her mom has one too.
I would love to have full day. It would just cost much less in daycare.
As Ontario gets set to extend its half-day kindergarten classes to full in 600 schools this year, all schools by 2015, a new study out today backs up moms like her. It concluded every $1 million spent on early learning could create as many as 29.3 new jobs, and every dollar invested could generate another $2.42 in benefits. Like parents not spending as much on daycare, moms and dads going back to work, their children onto university. Some research has shown early education increases the odds of kids entering post-secondary schools. It could even improve their health.
The benefits far outweigh the cost, and if you were a business, it would be a good thing to invest in.
But it comes with a big if.
Societal benefits.
The study was based on the suggestion every school in Ontario also provide before and after daycare. That's instead been left up to the individual boards. Many said they couldn't afford it. This mom doesn't want it.
I think they're going to spend the rest of their lives in school, and I think there's some value to being at home.
But the trend for full-day programs is on the rise. Most provinces have some form of all-day kindergarten, although they can come with a heavy tab. Without the necessary government funds, one school district near Edmonton decided to offer the full-time option this fall, but by charging parents a $300 monthly fee. This advocate says at least there's a choice.
We're taking resources and we're pouring them into one one-size-fits-all program that parents may or may not choose to use, but they'll end up paying for it in their taxes.
A debate Amelia wins for now. Her school isn't yet rolling out full-time kindergarten, meaning she still has a few more hours in her day to spend like this. Loren McNabb, Global News, Toronto.
The last week of summer break for most Ontario kids is off to a scorching start. Extreme heat advisories have been issued in Ottawa and Toronto. Temperatures reached the mid-30s, but felt closer to a sweltering 40 degrees with the humidity factored in. In this weather, seniors, young children, the homeless, and those with chronic illnesses are at high risk of suffering heat stroke. Toronto has opened 7 cooling centers for people to escape the sun. And it's expected to stay above 30 degrees in Toronto until Wednesday. That heat extends right into Atlantic Canada, where meteorologists are monitoring a different kind of extreme weather. Hurricane Earl was upgraded to a dangerous Category 4 storm this afternoon. And farther north, Hurricane Danielle is whipping up massive surf. Ross Lord is tracking the storms for us tonight.
The only impact Hurricane Danielle has had on the Maritimes is this: high waves, a godsend for surfers at beaches like Lawrencetown east of Halifax.
Danielle stayed pretty, really, really far out in the ocean, so it fed in a lot of really nice swell.
And scores of surfers are coming to ride these waves from other parts of Canada and the United States.
Today, it's not rocket science, it's just perfect. The wind's straight offshore, the swell's coming in, get out there and enjoy it.
They're wise to enjoy it while they can, because hurricane forecasters say the next one that's roaring up the Atlantic coast might not be so kind.
Well, Earl, the track of that is going to be further west than Danielle was, so that puts it, further upstream than Danielle was, so it's more likely to be a factor in our weather down the road.
If Earl does make landfall in Atlantic Canada, it's not expected until next weekend, but he's already a major hurricane, pounding the Caribbean, blowing at almost 195 kilometers an hour, with some gusts even higher. U.S. forecasters expect Earl to become even stronger in the next couple of days, stronger than Danielle ever was. And even though Danielle is breaking up in the North Atlantic, her wave action is still causing some problems. Lifeguards rescued more than 100 swimmers this past weekend at this beach in New Jersey. And a 25-year-old man has gone missing from a beach in Rhode Island.
A big wave came in and washed him off.
The rips are pulling as hard as we've seen them all summer long, and this is an extremely dangerous environment for even good swimmers, deadly for bad swimmers.
Forecasters say the water temperatures off Nova Scotia are 2 degrees warmer than normal. The warm water sometimes helps hurricanes maintain their power. Maritimers hope that won't be the case with Earl. Ross Lord, Global News, Halifax.
Now that the Gulf oil leak is capped, Alberta's oil sands are increasingly the target of environmental opposition. A new research published today adds fuel to the fire. A week after several major U.S. companies announced public boycotts, a University of Alberta researcher claims the industry may be causing even more damage to the Athabasca River than first thought. Here's Francis Salvaggio.
The mighty Athabasca River flows through some of Canada's most pristine wilderness and one of Canada's most toxic industries.
This one was taken from AR6 next to the upgraders. There's visible oil floating on the water.
For decades, both the oil sand industry and Alberta government maintained the pollutants found in the river were the result of seepage from the naturally occurring oil sand deposits. But Dr. Dave Schindler says his team found unusually high levels of lead, mercury, and other toxins in areas of the river that passed the massive projects.
We found that in almost every case, downstream of industry was where the highest concentrations were.
It's yet another blow to Alberta's economic juggernaut. Last week, the province was put on the defensive after several U.S. retail chains, including The Gap, announced boycotts to oil sand-related products.
Obviously, you don't like a negative image promoted from someone, especially when it isn't based on truth.
The province is in damage control mode. Premier Ed Stelmach has begun a letter-writing campaign to the CEOs of concerned American retailers. Many Albertans, though, have simply brushed off the critics.
We're not going to be able to do it with solar panels, so you can bark all you want, but it doesn't have any bite.
Today's research findings, though, could sting. The report is being published internationally and being taken seriously by some federal politicians.
We have to find ways to deal with the oil sands, to have them create that kind of wealth in a way that's sustainable for the environment.
Up till now, the Alberta government has maintained that strict regulations along the Athabasca have been met by industry. Researchers say their findings clearly suggest otherwise.
What we have going on right now is innuendo versus propaganda. So there is very little science in the background.
Francis Salvaggio, Global News.
With Canadian police and doctors voicing support to keep the long gun registry, the NDP leader is now promising a compromise. Jack Layton is allowing his MPs to vote freely on the private members bill and doesn't want to tip the balance in favor of scrapping it. So he's asking for a few changes that his caucus might support.
It will include penalties for non-registration, starting as non-criminal fines. Aboriginal treaty rights must be protected. Gun owners' privacy needs protection too. And there should never be a charge for long gun registration.
The Tories are already rejecting the request for compromise, saying the entire registry needs to be scrapped. The Liberals remain committed to voting as a group to keep it. A vote is expected September the 22nd. A medical marijuana study confirms what most pot smokers already know. The drug can help dull pain and improve sleep. Researchers at McGill University followed 21 people with chronic pain. Those that smoke capsules containing THC, the active ingredient in pot, reported significantly less pain than people in a placebo group. The dosages were small compared to what recreational pot smokers would receive, so the participants didn't get high at all, but still reaped the benefits. After a couple of false starts, an Australian man finally made his special delivery. And his labor of love brought him to Regina. We'll explain straight ahead.
Roger Clemens goes to court to clear his name and his baseball legacy. That's ahead on Global National.
Canada is where I got my start, where I learned to be a journalist. Thorough, solid, determined, and that grounding has taken me far.
Donna Friesen, NBC News, London, near Glasgow, Scotland, Moscow, Zurich, Cairo.
All around the world, in fact. And now I'm coming back to the place where it all began, the place where I belong. I'm coming home.
Global National with Donna Friesen begins Monday, September 20th.
Hey, Resolve Stainbusters. Look at the stain on my daughter's costume. Her school play is tomorrow. I can't let her go on stage looking like this.
She needs to remove that tough stain the first time.
Resolve Oxy Action by Spray and Wash.
Just add this with detergent to every wash load.
It has 50% more oxygen per scoop. It even removes this tough stain better than the leading brand.
I'm ready for my close-up.
New Resolve Oxy Action.
Spray and Wash is now called Resolve. Trust Resolve. Forget stains.
This area here used to be a mine. The distant hills has now been reclaimed to a forest. It's pretty important to us people hear about the good work that we're doing. Back about three decades ago, it was all about trees. Now we've gone from four or five types of trees, but also adding different types of shrubs and other types of plants. Oh, there's two squirrels chasing each other for a cone over here. Sorry to interrupt. It's pretty exciting that they're returning. We want to leave restored land that people are proud to see for generations after that.
Be ready with Get Active. Every day you take on life's challenges. You never give up. You give your best. And you have allies to help you win the fight. Take on life's daily challenges with a healthy diet, including DanActive, the only probiotic drink with 10 billion LKCI defenses bacteria. Here we go again. DanActivate every day.
2 for 5, 2 for 5, 2 for 5, 2 for 5.
Now you can choose. Any two Arby's roast beef, Philly beef and Swiss, or barbecue bacon melt sandwiches for only $5. All made with freshly sliced seasoned beef, oven roasted in store daily. It's gonna get you thinking Arby's. And don't forget our famous curly fries.
You're looking at new video of 33 miners trapped over 700 meters underground in Chile. For the first time in almost a month, they were able to speak by phone to loved ones on the surface. Each had about a minute to make a brief call. One miner used the opportunity to propose to his girlfriend. She, of course, said yes. Another encouraging note today, rescue teams finally began drilling a larger hole to get them out, but it's expected to take several months to complete. There's an update to a story we brought you a few weeks ago. An Australian man who's vowing to live life to its fullest has finally crossed number 23 off his bucket list.
Hey.
Sebastian Terry helped deliver a healthy baby boy in Regina. His plans to deliver two other babies fell through, but Carmen Kramer offered to include him on her big day. Little Oakley came into the world weighing 8 pounds and 15 ounces.
I have to admit, it's one of the most incredible days of my life, and then to witness this little guy coming into the world, I mean, it was amazing. I get emotional now, actually. It was amazing. It was incredible.
Terry will soon leave Canada to check off number 27 on his list. He'll preside over a wedding in California in September. Baseball legend Roger Clemens pleaded not guilty today to lying to Congress over allegations he used performance-enhancing drugs. It's the latest setback for a sport trying to emerge from an era of steroid abuse. Our Washington bureau chief Eric Sorensen was at the courthouse as Clemens entered his plea.
Roger Clemens emerged from court confronted by a crush of media, his baseball legacy now squarely on the line.
Roger, do you think this has been unfair to your reputation?
Clemens had nothing to say outside court. Inside, he uttered four words, not guilty, Your Honor. But it's what he told Congress 2 years ago that has him in hot water, testifying he didn't use performance-enhancing drugs.
Let me be clear. I have never taken steroids or HGH.
But his former trainer testified he gave Clemens drugs and that he kept the syringes.
I injected those drugs into the body of Roger Clemens at his direction.
It is an amazing story of human drama. One of them was lying. One of them was going to perjure themselves.
Clemens was voted the best in the league 7 times, more often than any pitcher in history. 2 award-winning years with the Toronto Blue Jays.
Strike 3 called, Rodriguez.
He's one of sport's biggest superstars to fall from grace.
Major League Baseball's reputation has been deeply damaged by drug use in recent years, and the denials by some players have only prolonged the scrutiny for themselves and their sport.
So arguably the best pitcher of his generation
and Bonds hits one high,
and maybe the best hitter, Barry Bonds, are now both before the courts. Others spent years denying drug use before admitting it. A generation of baseball records and future Hall of Famers now tainted.
The class of 2013 was supposed to be Sosa and Clemens and Bonds. Now who's it going to be?
Some stars, like Alex Rodriguez and Andy Pettit, have admitted their drug use and moved on with their careers. For Clemens, it's an all-or-nothing gamble that will either preserve or destroy his legacy. Eric Sorensen, Global News, Washington.
Time now to take a look at the financial numbers. The loonie lost almost 0.75 cents. The TSX rose slightly, and the Dow Jones dropped 140. Her whole life, she's wondered what happened to her father. A secret hidden deep within an Alberta glacier is finally revealed. That's next.
My first thought was, that means that he's not coming back.
Tomorrow,
A possible plot aimed at Parliament? Three men have been apprehended and charged, but so many questions remain unanswered. The investigation continues on tomorrow's Global National. MoneyWise on Global National is brought to you by Scotiabank. Let the saving begin.
Good afternoon. Ahead at 6, it'll be a sad first day of school for some St. Albert students. Their playground was deliberately destroyed. Plus, the controversy over the long gun registry continues, and the debate is no less heated among police.
Okay, we are ready for the saving lecture.
Yeah, you know all the sacrifices that we have to make.
Oh, yeah, and the total lifestyle overhaul.
Oh, yeah, and the condescending finger wag.
Oh, yeah, the wag is great.
Actually, we can help you each save an extra $1,500 this year automatically by saving every time you pay with your debit card, your credit card, and with every paycheck.
Well, I'll be.
A Scotia advisor can show you how you can let the saving begin. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank.
Sandra adores Activia's delicious taste. So when her mom suggested she have one every day for 14 days, she felt this wasn't much of a challenge. But she hadn't taken into account her husband's snack attacks, PA days, a shameless supermarket client, and her heartbroken friend.
When you take the Activia challenge, make sure to buy some extra. With its famous probiotic culture BL Regularis, Activia delivers on both benefit and taste.
Your inner driver to the all-new 2011 Mazda 2. It's zoom-zoom concentrated.
Zoom-zoom. When I was selling my place, my realtor helped with all the paperwork. You'd think I had a paper allergy or something.
And I'm not a real people person either. So my realtor helped with negotiations too.
All that back and forth, yuck.
And when it came to finding qualified buyers,
or a house with a park next door,
my realtor had all the answers.
So, thanks for everything, Dave.
Sally.
Rhonda.
Aziz.
Steve.
Cheryl.
Hi. I'm here to tell you about the new Quarter Pounder Deluxe from McDonald's.
No, I'm here to tell you about the new Quarter Pounder Deluxe.
No, I'm here to tell you. It's got lettuce, tomato, bacon.
Presenting Deluxe.
Succulent bacon.
No! It's my job to tell you about the Quarter Pounder Deluxe. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
An amazing discovery deep in Alberta's Columbia ice fields has solved a decades-old mystery. After 21 years buried under ice and snow, the body of an American hiker has been found. But for the man's family, it also brings heartbreak and also closure. Here's Global's Laurel Clark.
At the end, I was sorry to see it end. Total adrenaline rush.
The words of William Holland describe his final climb in detail before the pages go blank. Laurel Holland was just 5 years old when her father disappeared. She knew a climbing accident took his life, but with his body never found, she spent the last two decades wondering.
What if? It's sort of been this this question that I've never been able to fully answer, and have always had that in the back of my mind, that maybe somehow, someplace, some way, you know, he's out there.
4,000 kilometers from her New York City home, a melting glacier in the Columbia ice fields has revealed the answer. This month, hikers discovered William Holland's body 21 years after the climber fell from Mount Snowdome.
It was apparent that it had been there for a long time just from the equipment. And I was quite surprised that it was still a person. We removed the body of a person after that long.
Steve Blake says Holland's body was trapped in the glacier. The ice moved him roughly 1 kilometer over the years. He was found wearing one boot, the pack and rope still slung over his shoulder, as if he died just yesterday. On April 3rd, 1989, Holland and his climbing partner had reached the summit of the mountain. He was looking for a way down when a ridge of snow gave way. Severe conditions that day made it impossible for other climbers to reach him.
A simple mistake after climbing one of the toughest ice climbs in the area of the day.
And a heartbreaking one for his daughter. For Laurel, the discovery has unearthed grief and sadness, but it's also given her a way to fill in the missing pages.
And so that sense of finality has certainly been difficult. Obviously, the beauty of it is at least there is some closure.
Laurel Clark, Global News, Jasper.
I'm Peter Harris in Brockville, Ontario, where I'm learning javelin from a 97-year-old who's making me feel really out of shape. That's next on Global National.
I don't think you can throw that far, but you can try.
What do you mean I can't throw that far?
Better back off.
Good afternoon. The honeymoon has been cut short for a local couple after a fire ripped through their home, destroying everything inside. And investigators are suspicious about how the fire started. Find out why next. Plus, the city is cracking down on a White Avenue nightclub that's been the scene of several violent attacks. And an Edmonton researcher has discovered a way to prevent deadly infections in transplant patients, but he's still waiting for approval to use it here in Canada. Stay tuned for the news hour.
Introducing new French's Honey Mustard Dipping Sauce. It's so creamy and sweet. Once you start dipping, you just can't stop. French's. Happy starts here. Happy dipping.
Welcome to Wholesome, where Cracker Barrel cheese is always made without artificial preservatives. And like all cheese made from Canadian milk, it still contains no antibiotics and no artificial growth hormones. And where the local restaurant serves up nothing but the best.
Table for one.
Certainly.
Welcome to Cracker Barrel. Welcome to Wholesome. Now you can have a little Wholesome to go with Cracker Barrel cheese snacks.
The guys who drive a heavy-duty truck have some heavy-duty demands, like best-in-class horsepower and torque to get out of just about any situation. Best-in-class payload that beats the other guys flat out. A frame sturdy enough to bear best-in-class towing capacity of 21,700 pounds. And a braking system that's tough enough to bring it all to a stop. Heavy-duty demands? Gentlemen, your truck is ready.
Listen to your clothes. 97% of clothing labels warn against using chlorine bleach. Resolve Bright and White does the job without bleach. It keeps your whites looking whiter, your colors bright, and gets rid of stains.
Wow.
Resolve, amazing. The new name for spray and wash.
This week on ET Canada, all new interviews with Russell Brand, Owen Wilson, Bon Jovi, Kirsten Dunst, and P. Diddy.
This week on ET Canada.
Closed captioning of this program is brought to you in part by the partners in road construction safety. Please, don't rip through construction zones.
1,300 top athletes were in Ontario over the past week in a quest for athletic gold. But this competition was tinged with gray. And as Peter Harris shows us, one athlete was in a league all her own.
Clear the track.
She's the grand dam of the Canadian Senior Games.
It isn't the distance I throw that's important. It's that I take part and I keep with it. And where can I practice?
At 97 years old, Florence Storch is not only going the distance, she's going for gold.
When I used to run up at it, I could do better, but I've quit this running up business.
She's tossing the javelin at these national track and field games designed to promote active living for seniors. Her only competition in the over 85 age group, Elsie Rossi from Ontario. She's only 86.
Since my vision isn't so good, I don't do everything I used to do. But I don't even think about slowing down. I'm going to do what I've always done and keep it up.
4.02.
Not far, but for Florence, that's not the point.
My attitude is I like my farm. I like what I'm doing. I enjoy what I'm doing, and I'm still physically able to do it.
Always on the go, she came all the way from Alberta, not only to compete, but to cheer. Her son, Ed Storch, is a sprinter. At 66 years old, he's a young buck compared to his mom.
I prevailed. I won.
I've seen him win race after race, and I'm so proud. Sometimes there's a great space between him between first and second. Wasn't so great this morning.
A proud mother with 5 grandkids and 10 great-grandchildren. She taught for years in a single-room schoolhouse and is always up for sharing what she knows.
and aim at the horizon. You're aiming at the sky.
Okay, there's now somebody walking right in front of me. That's probably really dangerous.
I don't think you can circle that far, but you can try.
Her secret is simple. Eat right, work hard, and never stop moving.
Any plans of quitting anytime soon?
Oh, no. 2 years from now, I don't know where it's going to be, but I'm going to be there.
Proving faster, higher, and stronger doesn't have an age limit. Peter Harris, Global News, Brockville, Ontario.
Love that story. And that's Global National for Monday. I'm Gord Steinke. Thanks for watching. Local news continues now on most stations. Hope to see you tomorrow.
Monday, August 30th, you're looking live at the City Center Airport from our Global One News helicopter. Despite a possible plebiscite, council is continuing with its plans to redevelop the land. The news hour starts now.
Tonight on the news hour.
Cruising into Edmonton.
It was terrifying for about half an hour.
Passengers rescued from a cruise ship stranded in the Arctic are flown to our city for safety. Honeymoon horror. Only.